is Right Pricey Game Recap. And now, here is the star of the Price is Right Pricing Game Recap, Mr. Horgan.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to the Price is Right Pricing Game Recap Retro Edition.
Barker's Beauties.
That's why I chose to mention that fact right up to here. Yeah, it was a sad day for us Price is Right loyal friends and true. Well, gotta carry on. What price did Antonio believe was the bigger bargain? Was it the chair and ottoman at $618 at bargain price? Or was it the clock, which had a bargain price of $950? Antonio believed the bigger bargain went to the clock. All right, so let's go over to Janice with the chair and ottoman. Bargain price, $618. Actual retail price, $1,518. For a difference of $900. Now over to Kathleen with the clock. Bargain price, $950. Actual retail price, $1,550. For a difference of, let me find it. $600. Antonio did not win Barker's Bargain Bar, but he does still have the trip to Vegas, and he'll have his chance to spin the big wheel later on in the first showcase show. All right, Ben Mason, on to act number two. You know what to do. What is it?
Ooh.
Of course,
for the kitchen sink, they put natural Caroline
on that cupboard and was the third contestant to play a pricing game. She joined Bob up on stage near the giant price tag. Caroline gave Bob a kiss. And Bob mentioned that during the commercial break, he was discussing with the contestants what they like to win on the Price is Right, and everyone said cars, as that's truly an understatement. But there was actually something else that contestants like to win on the Price is Right. And for Caroline, you know what that was? A chance to win up to $10,000 in cash! That's right! Money, 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 money! Caroline was going to be playing Punch-A-Bunch. Janice held the $10,000 Bob Barker bill. And Kathleen...
Yeah. That's just great. Nothing quite like trying to give away some cold, hard greenbacks on the Price is Right.
I totally agree. And, yep, Janice held the bill. Kathleen modeled the four small prizes. And the first small prize was... the 20 questions game from University Games. Now, during Rod's description of 20 questions, we found out that Caroline is from the state of Michigan. And she, when Bob asked her where she was from, she answered that very softly. All right, now, the price of the 20 questions game wasn't $20, but the actual retail price was either higher or lower. Caroline guessed lower. And Kathleen revealed the price to be $30. That was higher. No punch, no prize there. Okay, on to the second small prize, which was a tot drum set. Nothing like having your little toddler grown up to be a rock star with a drum set. Okay, the wrong price was $18. Caroline believed the actual retail price was higher on that. Kathleen revealed the price to be $26. It was higher, so that she won that prize and a punch.
Very good.
All right, on to the third small prize. It was a document shredder. You can shred your shred unimportant documents. And receipts and all that other fun junk. And it came with a paper receptacle. Bob asked Rod if that could be used to shred bills, and it certainly could. As Rob said yes. Rob said yes. Okay, the price was not $75. Caroline's guess was lower for the actual retail price. Kathleen revealed the price to be $50, so she won that prize and another punch. And the final small prize was a handheld can opener. The price was not $23. Caroline believed the actual retail price was higher. Kathleen revealed the price to be $17. It was lower, so Caroline won two punches, so over to the punch board she went to punch her two holes. For the first punch, she gave that a very puny punch. And it was the puniest punch that Bob had ever seen. For her second punch, she punched harder and did a little better on how she did it. Now, for that first punch, which was located in the third row, eighth hole, Bob told Caroline she did quite well. And pretty good, actually. And how good did Caroline do? Well, she got $500.
Okay.
see what the next hole contains. Caroline said that she did not come to the Price is Right to win $500. She wanted to win more than $500. So she said that she was going to throw that away. Bob said, "You're the boss." She wanted. Let's see if she would get it, though. For her second and final punch, which was located in the second row, second hole, she threw away the $500, and in return, she ended up with... Well, it was a decision that she regretted. $100. But she didn't walk away empty-handed. She won $100, plus she won the top drum set and the document shredder that both of them together totaled $76. So she won $176 in cash and small prizes for a consolation win. And including the cupboard... Along with that supply of Bon Ami, Caroline currently won herself $1,763 in cash and prizes. All right, now before I move on to the first showcase showdown, I'd just like to say that closed captioning on The Price is Right was paid for in part by the following.
May I?
Please. Thank you very much, and you did really well. Very good.
Yeah, we should do that more often, but only on episodes that have, that closed caption plug.
It's a deal. All right, now, before the contestants spun the wheel, we discovered that Caroline was actually celebrating her 18th birthday on the tape date of this December 13th, 2000 show, so... Caroline, at the time, just made it, based on age, to make it on the show. Yeah, she just made it on.
That's right. If you turn 18 even on the day, then you're on the show. Nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong. Now, let's see how the contestants did on spinning the wheel. Antonio spun the wheel first. And for his first spin, he landed on one dime. That's 10 cents. Antonio chose to spin again. Bob suggested that he probably should. It's really a no-brainer. And in Antonio's second spin, he landed on 80 cents, giving him a total of 90 cents. Pretty good score. Now it was Caroline's turn to spin, and for her first spin, well, based on the way she spun the wheel, it looked like it was going to go all the way around. Unfortunately, Caroline landed on 15 cents, and to make matters worse, it did go all the way around. Boo! But Bob had poor pity on Caroline. He was telling the audience not to boo Caroline because she just turned 18. Well, Caroline had a chance of redemption to spin the wheel again. And to redo her first spin, she did get it all the way around. And she landed on 40 cents. So she had to spin again. She needed to get 50 to 60 cents in the second spin. And for her second spin, Caroline landed on... Oh, this would have been a great first spin. 95 cents! And Caroline went over with a total of $1.35. very close on landing on the 50 cents. If she had done that, she would have tied Antonio. But Bob still wished Carolina happy birthday. Now on to Christopher. Poor Christopher. All he won on The Price is Right was a new car. So let's see how much more damage Christopher did. For his first spin, Christopher landed on 30 cents. So he had to spin again. He needed to get 60 to 70 cents in the second spin. And in Christopher's second spin, he landed on 60 cents, giving him 90 cents, and he has tied Antonio. So that now meant Antonio and Christopher were going to have a spinoff. And starting off with Antonio, for his spinoff spin, he landed on, well, the dollar for a $1,000 bonus. And that meant Antonio was going to get a bonus. For Christopher to get a dollar, he could tie Antonio again if he's lucky. For Christopher's spin-off spin, he landed on 55 cents. But Christopher already won big in line him up, so he didn't have a bad day. Now it was time for Antonio's bonus spin. He only gets one spin in the bonus spin. Let's see if he had. Let's see if he could win an additional $5,000 or even $10,000 in the bonus spin. For Antonio's bonus spin, gave it a great mighty spin, and he ended up with a quarter. 25 cents. He came very close on getting into the section he needed, but the wheel just stopped a little short. But Antonio was headed to the showcase. So we'll find out later if Antonio did more winning. Now, if you at home would like to attend a taping of The Price is Right, it is just so easy to do it. Back in the day. Now, you're wondering, how do I get to The Price is Right? Let me fill you in. If you would like to attend a taping of The Price is Right, all you gotta do is send a request, along with the number of tickets and the date you wish to attend, on a self-addressed stamped envelope to Tickets, The Price is Right, CBS Television City, 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036. And now, Ben Mason, we're on to act number 4. Can't believe we're already into the second half.
Included an Olympic weight tree and a complete set of cast barbell plates.
jumping the gun.
And I think I might know why. Just take a look at some.
All right. And I'd like to note that during his come on down, CBS News did a little break-in saying that Vice President Al Gore was going to address the nation around 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Yep. And Forrest was, like, demonstrating, in a way, his come on down. And he was practicing that. All right, on to the next item up for bids, which was a 21 board game collection. It included games such as Pictionary, Uno, Outburst, and Clever Endeavor. And the winner of that board game collection would receive a supply of Zyx Arthritis Pain Relief, all modeled by Janice. Here are the bids. Forrest, $300. Julie, $500. Jacqueline, $575. And Linda, $301. And the actual retail price of the board game collection was $504. Julie was the next contestant to play a pricing game. She was off by $4. That was a very good bid there. Now, Julie, who was celebrating her 18th birthday the day before she attended this taping, well, Bob had the perfect birthday present for her, and that was a new car! And as the Beanstalker plays, I will mention that Julie was playing for a 2001 Ford Escort ZX2 two-door coupe. It came with air conditioning and automatic transmission. It's the Ford Escort ZX2, modeled by Kathleen. It was very nice of Rod to say happy birthday to Julie during his description. Now, Julie's pricing game for this 2001 Ford Escort ZX2 was card game. Ooh, one of my favorites. Now, to determine how close Julie had to come to the actual retail price of the car without going over, she had to draw the range card. And the range card she drew, with Bob encouraging her that the bigger the better, was, well, at the time, she drew the biggest card in that deck, $2,000. So that meant Julie had to come within $2,000 of the actual retail price of the car without going over. And we know how the game is played. So Julie cut the cards, and she was given a starting bid of $8,000, which at the time was the starting bid. Now, for her first card, she drew the Queen of Diamonds. So that's $1,000 added, making the price $9,000. Julie decided to draw again, and the second card was the Three of Diamonds. So that's another $300 added, making the price $9,300. Julie decided to draw again, and the third card she drew was the Four of Diamonds. So that's another $400 for a total of now $9,700. For her fourth card, she decided to go on. She drew, you know, they say diamonds are a girl's best friend, and this very much explains it. The Seven of Diamonds. That's another $700, making the price $10,400. Julie decided to draw again, and for her fifth card, she drew the Queen of Spades. So that's $1,000 added, making the price $11,000. so Julie gave a bid of $11,400. She had to come within $2,000 of the actual retail price without going over. And when Bob revealed the actual retail price of the Ford Escort ZX2, it turned out to be $14,125 for a difference of... Find the right cue. $2,725! Oh, no! Julie lost by $725. She had drawn at least one more card, she probably would have had it. And Bob told Julie that when she grows up to be an old grandma, she could tell her grandkids that she came very close on winning a car on her 18th birthday. Well, Julie still has the board game collection. Alright, Ben Mason, we're on to act number 6. We're heading into the home stretch now.
You bet we are. Now, Bob asked Roddy if he would find one more contestant, another contestant. Roddy willing to bet if he said those magic words, it would happen. That final contestant seated down the row was...
Exactly, with that red one-piece suit, you bet.
Bye.
joint supplements from Chef. Contestants not appearing on stage will receive outdoor products, luggage, and sports gear. And the Fat Eliminator and Strength and Grace workout videos by Minna from Optimizer Workouts. And now here's Ben Mason with our Showcase Showdown. Man, that wheel was hot! And it seems legit. I'm about to go crazy though. Showcase. case was Forrest, who got himself $11,000 on the big wheel. And the runner-up was Antonio, who got himself $1,000 on that big wheel. Now on to the first showcase. And this showcase first started off with a new bedroom group. From Wick's Furniture, it was the Home Furnishing 7-Piece Contemporary Bedroom Group. And to go along with that bedroom group was the Longa Burger Company Bedding Ensemble. Make that bed very nice. And for a comfortable night's sleep was a new mattress set. It was the Springwall Queen Size Chiropractic Mattress and Box Spring Set. That entire bedroom group was modeled by Janice. And the next prize was a Knight, K-N-I-G-H-T, golf club package modeled by Nikki. And those golf clubs would pair nicely with the Easy Go 2-passenger Freedom Luxury Golf Cart that was driven by Kathleen. And this showcase can be Forrest's or Antonio's if the price is right. Forrest chose to pass that showcase to Antonio instead of bidding on it. And Antonio gave a bid of $12,250. Now on to showcase number two. This showcase contained prizes revealed about what animals are thinking. And the first animal was a turtle who was thinking about how to move faster. And the prize in question was a Yamaha V-Star Classic Motorcycle modeled by Kathleen. The next was for a house bird who is very clamped up in its cage, would have more space if it had this, a Gazebo Enterprise 8-foot diamond gazebo modeled by Nikki. Finally, we had a fish who wish could swim in more open water, like in a trip to Tahiti. His round-trip coach for two from Los Angeles to Tahiti and then on to Bora Bora for a 6-night stay at the Hotel Sofitel Coralia. And the trip was modeled by Kathleen. And this showcase containing prizes revealed as what animals are thinking can be Forrest's if the price is right. Forrest gave a bid of $19,500. Alright, when it was time for the actual retail prices to be revealed, Bob went to Antonio first. Antonio's bid was $12,250. The actual retail price of Antonio's showcase was $13,400 for a difference of $1,150. Pretty good bid there. Now over to Forrest. Forrest's bid was $19,500. And the actual retail price of Forrest's showcase was $17,085. Forrest went over, and that meant Antonio was the showcase winner! And as Forrest congratulated Antonio for his showcase win, he was going to shake Bob's hand again, but Bob held back because when Bob and Forrest shook hands, Forrest gave a pretty strong grip on Bob's hand. So instead, Bob patted Forrest on the shoulder. And he deserved that pat on the shoulder, especially how he won his pricing game and how he won $11,000 on the big wheel. As for Antonio, he won himself a grand total of $15,608 in cash and prizes. What a good day for him. So, we had line them up, switch, and high-low as the three pricing games won back on December 13th, 2000. And we also gave away, was the Talk Drum set and the Document Shredder and Puncher Bunch. And a whole lot of cash was given away. To be specific, $18,100. Caroline won $100 in Puncher Bunch. Antonio won $1,000 in Showcase Showdown number one. And in Showcase Showdown number two, Stephanie won $6,000 and Forrest won $11,000. Man, the wheel was definitely on fire on that show. Now, the contestant recognition contestants are Antonio for his winnings, including the $1,000 bonus, to Caroline for her small Punch-A-Bunch win, and the MVPs of The Price is Right are Christopher, Estefany, and Forrest. Pricing Recap Retro Edition has been sponsored by Game Boy Color, available in grape and berry. There you go. Alright, so thank you all for watching this latest installment of the Price is Right Pricing Game Recap Retro Edition. Ben Mason, I can't wait for us to do this again the next time we join.
You betcha. I'll be here, and you will too, Mr. Morgan.
Absolutely. All right. Until next time, this has been Mr. Morgan from Woodbridge, New Jersey.